Welcome to Academic E-Learning. Now we are going to see the topic disk drive components under the subject information storage management. Okay, so here disk drive is nothing but the hard disk drive. We are just going to see about the structure of the hard disk drive. Okay, so hard disk drive is the storage media where we can store and retrieve our data. Okay, the components are the plater, spindle, read write head, ARM assembly, and that of the controller. So here is the structure of the disk drive components. Here you can see the plater. So plater is having many concentric rings, and all the platers are connected by the spindle. And here you can see a read write head, so which is used to perform the read and write operations on the plater, and it is mounted on the actuator arm, and all the actuator arm are mounted on the arm assembly. Okay, and next, this set of plater are sealed in a case that is called as head disk assembly, and here we can see a power connector, and also here we can see an interface which is used to connect the disk drive to the host. Okay, so next comes the plater. So here plater consists of a hard disk drive consists of one or more flat circular disk that is called as plater, and here the data is recorded in the form of binary, that is of zeros and that of the ones. Okay, and this set of platers are sealed in a case that is called as head disk assembly, and the most important thing is the plater is having two surfaces, and both the surfaces are coated with the magnetic material, and data can be written to or read from both the surfaces of the plates. Okay, and the total capacity of the drive is depends on two things. One is the number of the plates and the capacity of each plates. Okay, so here we can see the structure of the spindle and the set of plates. And next comes the spindle. So spindle is used to connect all the plates, and this spindle is connected to the motor, and this motor is rotated at the constant speed. Okay, so now we are having a disk drive that is having the speed of about 7200 rotations per minute, or 10,000 rotations per minute, or 15,000 rotations per minute. Okay, and we are having the diameter of the plater as 90 millimeter or 3.5 inches. Okay, next we are going to see about the read write heads. Okay, that is this, with the help of this read write head only we can perform the read and the write operations on the platers. That is, during a read and the write, this read write head is just going to senses the magnetic polarization. The most important thing is it never touches the surfaces of the plater. That is, when the spindle is rotating, this read write head should not touch the surfaces of the plater. Therefore, we are having some air gap between the read write head and the plater. This gap is called as head flying height. Okay, so when the spindle is stop its rotating, then this read write head is going to land it on the area near to the spindle. That area is called as landing zone. Okay, so when a head crash occurs, means this is due to the malfunction of the drive, or accidentally when the read write head touches the surfaces of the plater rather than the landing zone. Okay, therefore this leads to the damages to the read write head and also result in the data losses. Okay, so here is the structure of the actuator arm assembly. So next topic is the actuator arm assembly. Here we can see many actuators, and the read write head is mounted only on the actuator arm, and all this actuator arm is mounted on the actuator arm assembly, And the most important thing is this read write head on all the surfaces must be moved at the same time. Okay, so next comes the controller. So controller is nothing but the circuit board which is mounted at the bottom of the disk drive. It's having four components. One is the microprocessor, and next one is the internal memory, and next one is the circuitry, and next one is the firmware. And this firmware is going to perform the most important task of the controller, that is it just going to control the power and the speed of the spindle motor. As we all know, the spindle is going to connect all the platers and the spindle is going to connect to the motor. Okay, therefore the speed and the power of the motor is managed only by the firmware, and it also going to manage the communication between the drive and the host, and it is responsible for switching between the different read write heads among the platers, and it is going to control the read and the write operations, and also it just going to perform the data access. Okay, so next comes the physical disk structure. So in this topic we are going to see three things. One is the track, and next one is sector, and next one is the cylinder. Okay, so track is nothing but a concentric ring, and all the tracks are numbered, that is outer track is having the number 0, and you are having a term that is track per inch, that is number of tracks per inch. It is just going to determine how tightly the tracks are packed on the platter. And next one, the sector, this is nothing but all the tracks are divided into smaller unit, that is called as sectors. In olden days, all the tracks are having the same number of sector. For example, 17 sectors per track. Okay, but nowadays the number of sectors per track is vary according to the specific drive. Therefore, the number of the sectors and the number of the tracks is depend on two things. One is the dimensions of the plater and the recording capacity of the platers. Okay, so here is the diagram that shows the disk structure. Here we can see about sector, platers and tracks, and the top of all the platers are connected by this spindle, and we are having this cylinder. Okay, so what is a cylinder? Cylinder is nothing but it is just going to identify the set of identical tracks on each surfaces of every plate. Cylinder zero means it's just going to identify the track zero of all the platers. Okay, all the platers. And here the most important thing is, in addition to the user data, the sector is also going to store some amount of information, like sector number, what is the head number or that of the plater number or that of the track numbers. These data are called as metadata. Okay, here the head number is nothing but plater number. Okay, plater number is nothing but the surface number, that is each plater is having two surfaces, right? So upper surface and that of the lower surface. For example, head 0 means it's just going to indicate the upper surface surfaces, and head 1 means it's just going to indicate the lower surfaces. Okay, but in general we are having two term. One is the unformatted capacity disk drive, and second one is the formatted capacity of the disk drive. Usually the manufacturers are advertised only the unformatted capacity. Okay, for example, 500 GB of disk drive. In general, the user cannot store 500 GB of user data. Okay, rather they can use only 465 amount of user data. So nearly 35 GBs of the data sectors are used to store this metadata only. Okay, so this is about the physical data structure. And next comes the zone bit recording. Okay, so zone bit recording means the outer tracks. Okay, so in this the grouping of tracks is called as zoned bit. Okay, so here the outer track, in general outer tracks can hold more data rather than the inner track, because of they are physically longer, but both the outer tracks and the inner tracks are having the same number of sectors. Okay, so the data density was low on the outer track, so this leads to the inefficient use of the available spaces. Okay, so this problem is avoided with the help of the zone bit recording. Okay, so this is nothing but grouping of tracks into the zones, and all the zones are numbered. That is, zone 0 means it's just going to indicate the tracks, outer tracks. Okay, so in this here we are seeing two diagrams. The left is the platter without the zone and right is a platter with the zones. Okay, so here we are having concentric rings, that is called as track, and all the tracks are divided into some are divided into smaller units, that is called as sectors. Okay, so here we can see three zones, that is zone 0, zone 1 and that of zone 2. So zone 0 consists of the outer two tracks, and the next two tracks are considered as zone 1, and next two tracks are considered as zone 2. Okay, this is about the zone bit recording. And the most important thing is, when the application is giving more priority to the performance means, then it should store this data only on the outer tracks. Okay, so next comes the logical block addressing. So in this topic we are going to see about two addresses. One is the physical address and next one is the logical addresses. Okay, so physical address is going to represent three address. One is the cylinder number, and next one is the head number, and next one is the sector number. Okay, so cylinder number 2 means it's just going to identify the track 2 on each surfaces of every platter, and head number 0 means it is just going to represent the outer upper surfaces, upper surface, and sector number 10. Okay, so this is about the physical addresses, and logical address is going to represent the block number. Okay, therefore it is a responsible of the controller to translate the logical bit, logical block addresses to the cylinder head sector addresses. Okay, we all know about the size of the disk drive in terms of gigabytes or megabytes, but we need to know about the size of the disk drive in terms of number of blocks. Okay, and the most important thing is, the logical block is mapped to the physical sector on a 1:1 basis. That is one logical block is going to point only one physical sector. Okay, and for example, if you are having your disk drive that is having 8 sectors per track, and 8 sectors, that is, it is having 8 sectors per track, and you are having 4 cylinders, and we are having 8 heads, means therefore the number of blocks present in that disk drive will be around 256 blocks. Therefore the blocks are numbered from 0 to 255, that is all the blocks are having unique addresses. Okay, so this is about the disk drive components. So in this we see the detailed structure of the disk drive in terms of platter, spindle, read write heads, and ARM assembly, and that of the controller, and the physical disk structure, and that of the zone bit recording, and also the logical bit addressing. Okay, so hope you all are very clear with the concept. If you are having any doubt, please comment in the comment section. Thanks for watching.